Today I'm gonna show you how to solve ACM ICPC team HackerRank problem in an easy way right now. Hey everyone, my name is Kanaya Gupta and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any update. Let's start. In this problem, there are a number of people who will be attending ICPC World Finals. Each of them may be well versed in a number of topics. Given a list of topics known by each attendee, you must determine the maximum number of topics a 2-person team can know. Also find out how many ways a team can be formed to know that many topics. List will be in the form of bit string, where a string represents an attendee, and each position in that string represents a field of knowledge. 1 if it's known field, or 0 if it's not. For example, given 3 attendees, data as follows. So these are the 3 attendees. You can see here, in each an individual bit represent the knowledge in the known field. So these are all possible teams that can be formed via these 3 people. Just consider this one is first, this one is second, this one is third. These are the 3 people, and each an individual bit represent, suppose we have a 5 subjects, then each an individual bit represent the knowledge in 5 subjects. So if you see, 1 means this guy, person 1, has a knowledge about A subject. 0 means he doesn't have a knowledge about B subject. 1 means again he has knowledge about C. 0 means no knowledge. And 1 means again has a knowledge about E. So the first person knows 3 subjects very well, A, C and E. And in the similar way, second person know all those 4 initial subjects A, B, C, D except E. So like that, we have a different person or student or attendee, whatever you can say, they have different knowledge in each subject. Some people know some subject, some people know other subject. The first part of this question is we have to form a team in such a way so that the team knows the maximum number of subject. This is the first part. And the second part is we have to tell how many ways the team can be formed, right? So in that, if you see, this is the explanation of these 3 attendees, 1 and 2. So if you take 1 and 2, if you include both the guys, or means form a team by including 1 and 2, so you can see both will be knowing all the subjects, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means nothing, just a A, B, C, D. So if you talk about first guy knows and second person also knows A, first person doesn't know about B, but second know about B. So overall, as a team, they know about B subject also. So in the same way, C both guys knows, D first guy doesn't know but second guy knows, and E first guy knows not the second guy. So overall, if you see, by comparing this, that some subjects is known by first, some subject known by a second person. So both guys when form a team, they are able to capture or understand all subjects. So that is the reason you can see, and this is a max what they can do. So in this problem, this can be the maximum one that after forming a team, they can know only the maximum subject whatever is given. So we have given 5 subjects, and these 2 guys after forming a team are able to cover all 5 subjects. So this is a 1 pair or 1 team guys. The next team is 1 and 3. So if you form team with 1 person or 1 attendee with 3 attendee, then you can see this 3 attendee doesn't know much. He know only the 4th subject, means D. So he can help this guy in a D. So after forming a team, 1 with 3 if form a team, they will only be able to cover 1, 3, 4, 5. It means 1, 3, 4, 5. D will not be covered because in both the attendee, we can see they don't have knowledge about the B subject. So if they form a team, they will not be able to cover the B subject. So in the similar way, second and third, this is the second person and this is a third person. If both will form a team, so you can see this guy have a knowledge about all four subject, and this guy have a knowledge about only fourth subject. So if they will form a team, they will not be able to cover the fifth subject. So these are the basically the coverage part has been given, that once you form a team, how many subjects they can cover. So if they form a team of 1-2, they are able to cover 5, and they are form a team of 1-3 and 2-3, they are able to cover this. Or first part of this question is you have to print the maximum number of subject you can cover. So what is the maximum number of subject you can cover? You can see this is a 5, right? So the output will be 5 for the first part. In the second part is find how many ways a team can be formed to know that many topics. So how many ways we can form this team? There's only one way, which is represented over here. We can't see any other team which is covering 5 subjects, right? Which is the maximum one. So there's only one way to do it. So this is what the problem, guys. Let's see the input format. The first line contains two space separated integer N and M, where N represent the number of attendees and M represent the number of topics. Each of the next N line contains a binary string of length M. If the ith line's jth character is 1, then the ith person knows the jth topic. Let's understand this, guys. So these are the values of N and M. So you will be given N, which is nothing, just the number of attendees. So how many attendees we have? We have 4 attendees. And 5, this shows the number of topics or number of subjects. So you can see 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the number of topics. Among these topics, how much knowledge they have, so you have to calculate. And each bit represent, if it's a 1, it means they have a knowledge about it. If it's 0, it means they don't have a knowledge about that subject. And the output, we have to print in the first line, print the maximum number of topic a 2-person team can know. And the second line, print the number of ways to form a 2-person team that knows the maximum number of topics. So I hope, guys, now this problem is clear to you what we are going to achieve in this problem. Let's try to build the logic around it. I have taken the same input, guys, which is present in the HackerRank platform. So if you see, these inputs is nothing, is the attendee data. The one attendee knows about the subject or not. So this is the binary data. So if 1 represent he has a knowledge about that first subject, and 0 represent he doesn't have a knowledge about the second subject. So once you are when you are going to form a team, you have to think in a team perspective. Or you can say, if in a team one person knows about one question and second person knows about the second question, it means as a team they both knows two questions. So we have to see the maximum number of subjects we can cover while forming a team. So just take example, this is a first attendee and this is the second one. So individually, first guy will know about first, third and fifth subject. The second guy knows first, second, third, but he doesn't know fourth and fifth. So if you talk about as a team, once you form a team of both these two guys, so as a team, how many subjects they knows? They knows one, both knows one. They knows, this guy knows two, so it's fine, this guy knows two. Three, the both guy knows, and five. So you see, they knows four subject. Individually, they know three, but as a team, they knows four subjects. So what I have done actually, so if you see how we have get this result, this is nothing, this is just a union of X and Y, where X is the first attendee and Y is the second attendee. So if you do the union of both, you'll get this. So it means once you form a team, you have to get the union. So once you do the union, you will come to know how many subjects as a team you can cover. But how we are going to do that union in a program? So union, because we know these are the binary flags as mentioned in a HackerRank question, because 1 represent they have a knowledge and 0 represent they doesn't have a knowledge about the subject. So the same thing in a program can we achieve by using the OR operator, binary OR. So if you do the binary OR of X and Y, you will get 1, 2, 3, 5. How you will get 1, 2, 3, 5? So if you do the binary OR with X and Y, let's see what you will get. So if you see what is X here, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. What is Y here? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And when you do X or Y, what you will get? 1, 0, little 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is what you will get. And if you represent in terms of numbers, so you can see there is no difference at all. This is the same thing what we have done it. So X or Y is the same thing as X union Y. So I hope you got the idea, guys, how you are going to capture the team data in a program. So as a team, you have to just calculate the X or Y, so you'll know as a team how many subjects these attendees knows. So now that we have to do for all the pairs or for all the teams, we have to check how many subjects they know, and we have to check for the maximum one. The maximum the subject we can cover, that will be our answer. The first part, what the first part says, you have to calculate the maximum number of topics that can be covered via team. So here if you see, we are covering 4 topics, but overall we have 5, right? So we have to check the maximum number of topics that can be covered via team. This is the first part. And the second part is, we have to check how many teams or different combinations are there which will do that. So to check each and every pair, there will be a loop required. So we will be having a 2 for loop, 1 which will go to n, and there will be another for loop inside that which will go to n. So once you do the nested for loop, what it will do, it will just form the each and individual pair, and we have to check as a team a topic, right? So how many subjects we are going to cover as a team. So first, what we are going to do, we are going to see how many topic we are going to cover, which can we calculate via I union J. In that, we are going to maintain I or J. So we are going to do OR operation here, guys. So whatever the result will come, we will store in a variable which is called IUJ, means I union J. Okay. So once we store that result, so now we have this result for a pair. So like that, you for all the pairs, you will be having this result, and that you have to check how many bits are enabled, or you can say how many bits are set. So for that, you have to just get the bit count. So you can do get count. So there will be some function or maybe your own logic which will get the bit count for you, whatever we have stored. So as a team, whatever we have stored, we'll get the bit count from there. So now you know the bit count, how many bits are set. So now you have to check whether that bit is maximum or not. So there will be some variable. Suppose you have to take the max topic. So if that bit count is greater than max topic, then max topic is the thing, this guy, it represents how many maximum topic we can cover. So if bit count means is more than the maximum topic, we'll store the bit count there. So now the maximum topic will cover the bit count, the maximum one, which we are going to show as the output, because we have to capture the output which covers the maximum bit count. But we have a second part also. In second part, we have to tell how many different teams can be formed, right? So this is just for maximum count. How you are going to calculate the different ways or the maximum team can be formed? For that, we are going to add one more thing. Whenever we found a bit count or store, we'll store a count as 1. It means we found a 1 team. Else max count or max topic is equals to bit count, In that case, we are going to increment the count. What it does, guys, if we have found a bit count which is greater than the previous one, it means this is the first team we have got, right? So in that case, we are going to increment the count 1. The team count is 1 basically. But if the maximum topic or the bit count are same, it means this is another team with the same count. So we are incrementing the count. It means there are two ways to form that team, right? So this is the main logic, guys. And after that, we can just close the for loop. And at the end, what is the value of maximum count or maximum topic we have, maximum topic and count, we can return that. So at the end, we can just print the maximum topic and the count value. So I hope, guys, you got this idea what we have done. Let's see the algorithm in action, guys. So this is the method, guys, ACM team, which is given in a HackerRank platform. And this is the string array, which we are accepting as a parameter. So I've taken a length of the array. Here I've taken a big integer. Guys, I am doing this coding in a Java, but if you are from any other background, I'll suggest you to use their data structure, whatever is present, or replacement of a big integer, or write it manually if it's not. So this is the big integer class. I have taken an array of big integers. So first, what I'm doing, I'm just taking the each and every element or string from the array and putting in a big integer. Why I'm doing that, we'll see. So I've taken the same variable as I discussed, maximum topic and the team count. So there's a two for loop, guys. We have just discussed why two for loop, because we have to check for the each and every pair. So after that, I'm just taking the union. So this is the union, guys, because for each and every string, I have to do the union with the other one. So this is, I am storing in a I union J. After doing this union, I am just checking the bit count in that. The same we have discussed in the algorithm, guys. So this is a bit count. If bit count is maximum, I am storing that bit count inside a max topic. So that max topic will be having the bit count. And assigning the team count as a 1, because this is the first time we have got the team which knows these many maximum number of subject knowledge, or we can say this is the team which knows maximum number of knowledge. If this is not the case and bit count and maximum count are equal, I am increasing the team count. It means this is the second way or the second team which also has the same maximum topic. So once the two for loop ends, we have a data in a max topic and a team count. The max topic will hold the answer for the first part, in that this is the what we can achieve at max. So we are storing both the values in our array and returning that array. Let's try to run this algorithm in a HackerRank, guys. So I pasted the code here. Let me run this. So you can see, guys, sample test case got passed. Now I'm submitting this code. So congratulations, guys, all test case got passed. Guys, I hope this problem is clear to you. If you find this video helpful, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching it.